Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to put FabFilter Pro Q4's new what I call heat mode. Technically it's called, let's read what it's technically called, the character button. We're going to put it to use today and see what it actually does on a scientific level. Okay, so if you're new to FabFilter Pro Q, this is a new feature that we've never had before. In short, character usually means shifting the timbre of something, shifting the harmonic emphasis of something. That's usually what character means, or it means adding frequencies to a sound, harmonically speaking. So we could take one frequency and add more frequencies to make it feel more full. So today I'm going to show you guys the experiment I have running here. Firstly, we are running in Patcher just to show you guys the setup. It's a lot of screen real estate here. Basically, I have one, here's the chain. I have audio coming into FL. We're running through a pre-EQ. So this is used as a leveler. The harder I push, I'm trying to see how much saturation we get if we push harder into FabFilter versus just how much saturation we get by default. Okay, so we have a pre-EQ, which is the gain going into FabFilter Pro Q4. Nextly in the chain is FabFilter Pro Q4. We have this, again, I call it heat mode because it's just fire, but it's called the character button technically. And I have this set to warm mode, which I assume is their most harmonically rich one. And we'll go back and forth with the subtle modes on that one as well. I'm losing all my windows here. Okay. And then from here, we have the post EQ. And the post EQ's job is just turning the volume back up or down depending on the input signal so that it compensates for the gain that we push into Pro Q4. Now that you guys know the experiment, here's how we're going to run it. We're going to run it using the knob here. So as you guys can see, as I turn the knob, it adjusts the gain equally. Okay. So it has an auto gain basically. Okay. All that geekiness being said, we're going to run a sine wave. I'm not going to like blow you guys' ears out by just playing it constantly because it'll just blow your ears off. I might unmute here and there though. Okay, so right now we have a mute signal, so you shouldn't be hearing anything. Now, as I turn this knob to the right, we should see more horizontal lines on this graph to the right, which is called Wave Candy in FL Studio. We should see more lines to the right. Now, actually, we should really do one more thing here, which I forgot to do. We should zoom in a little bit more on Wave Candy. To do this, let's open up Wave Candy and change your update to more bands, I believe, and then turn your update speed. And what else do we need to do? Turn scale up. That's what it is. Okay, so let's mess with the update speed here. Okay, there we go. And now we have more high-res bands here. So now we can really see the harmonic character of a sound by zooming all of the way in. Now let's run this experiment. Again, if you guys want to, you know, blow your speakers off, here's the actual tone. All right, so I decided to play the signal at a low level so that we're not just like gonna go crazy listening to this tone. Let's open up all the windows so we can see everything moving at once. All right, now for the final test, here we're gonna look to the right, and don't mind that distortion in the beginning, it's just because of the note length. Let's go to the surface and let's turn up our knob. So as you guys see, I'm running out of screen real estate. Okay, now let's crank the knob and we should see more horizontal lines or more purple. As we can see here, we see more horizontal lines. Now to get to that point, I had to crank the signal almost, 12 dB for it to even trigger into Pro Q4's what I call heat mode. So look at how much gain I had to add to the signal for it to even activate this mode. So the question is, are people truly using the mode? That's my question. Now, also too, I wanna make sure that I have auto gain compensation off because now it says I'm clipping on the output. So we wanna make sure it's not just the clipping. All right, cause let's pull that back just to make sure it's not just the clipping. So it's not purely auto gain, but it doesn't matter. Okay, so we are creating harmonics, but we had to push into the EQ 12 dB. To even get to that point, at least from where the signal was before. So you guys can see how hard we have to push into the actual sound for that to even occur. Most people probably think they're getting a sound, but if you're not pushing hard enough into it, you're probably creating really faint harmonics. Okay, so this is again 12 dB of gain, or now it's at 18 dB, just to get harmonics all the way up to 1K. So if we started at, you know, if our fundamental frequency is at what, 50 hertz, and our second harmonic's at 100, third harmonic is at 150, then it's 200, then 250, and then 300, 350, 400, 450. So that's how we get all these series of harmonics coming in. Let's see if we gradually pull it back. Now the weird part about this is that once I push it past a certain level, let's say 12 dB, it just kind of goes straight into the harmonics. Now it is very faint here, okay, pushing it at about 12 dB, but when we push it just above 12, it just goes straight into the upper harmonics. So let's switch the mode. Let's go back to subtle mode. Let's see what this does to the sound, if anything. Okay, so by default, it's just a simple horizontal line, which is our fundamental frequency. And now subtle mode, even though it's called subtle, I see more intensity in the energy in the graph. So even though it's called subtle, I'm seeing more activity. Let's count the harmonics here. We have 50, 100, we have 150, we have 200, we have 250. Okay, so they're not switching the math. It just seems to be more emphasis on specific harmonics, which it looks like they're emphasizing the seventh harmonic here at 350. And they're emphasizing the third harmonic. So the third and the seventh harmonic seem to be more pronounced. Whereas in the warm mode, we didn't have that same distribution of energy. So let's go back to warm mode. And now we're kind of seeing more. I wonder if something changed here. Because it wasn't that active before. Okay, so warm is giving us a different signature. I don't remember it being that intense. Let's switch modes again. Let's go back to subtle. Okay, so warm must have been more linear. Okay, so subtle is just certain harmonics being emphasized. So what does this sound like? Let's pull up the levels. Again, I'm not going to play this forever because it will drive us crazy. Okay, so there is the aftertone. Let's go back to Pro Q4. Hold on, yeah, I have like 1,000 screens open. This is hard to manage here. Let's pull Pro Q4 up. Okay, so now let's go back to subtle mode. And we need to go to our knob here and start. So here's before. No harmonics. Remember, the sweet spot is like 12 dB from this sound, I mean. And now we really hear those harmonics. I'm sure we could drive it even further, but you guys get the gist. Okay, so it takes a lot of gain to trigger that effect. And I think most people are tricking themselves thinking something's happening. So let's go to warm modes, the same thing. Now I've noticed too, warm mode doesn't require as much gain to trigger the second harmonic, whereas the other one does require a significant amount of gain. So here the second harmonic is just steady. And then it opens up. All right, so that is the geeky science behind that. I'm actually surprised how hard you have to push a sound to get it to trigger. Now let's use this on real world sounds. And to save some screen real estate, we're just gonna collapse it to our Wave Candy spectrum. That way we're not doing too much. Okay, so let's do instrument at a time. Let's do the drums. Actually, let's start with the bass. And we need to run this through channel, what is this, 6. So everything needs to run through 6. Let me think of a fast way to do this. Let's do this, boom. Just to show you guys, I'm gonna turn off all the effects on the other channels so that it runs straight through 6. And then we have our drums here. We're gonna run those straight through 6. They have no effects on. This is why this is grayed out. Okay, so everything's running through 6 right now. Okay, so let's use our knob to, you know, adjust these harmonics. I'm gonna turn my mic off. Here's before. Okay, so I'm not really hearing much of a difference there. It's more so rounding it off if we push the sound into it more, because when you add more frequencies, it's just making the other frequencies in the area seem quieter. So really it's more rounding that off than it is making it stand out. Let's run the drums through it now. Now you really hear it on the drums. Here's before. All Now we're cranking into the saturation here. You can really hear it when you push it past that 12 dB point. You really hear the crunch now. All right, so here's before. You hear that crunch? Okay, so we do definitely hear it with the drums because you just feel the attitude and the sound. Lastly, let's go to our sample and see if it adds any kind of vibe to the sample. Here's before. Now what I'll do for the sample is artificially push some of the gain, that way we're really going heavy into it. Now the thing is, we're not going to get gain compensation here. Actually, what I'll do is I'll just lower the fader. I can hear that ripping a part of the sample. All right, so here's before, let's start turning it up. You can hear with the dun, 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 listen to that sound, you'll hear that, like the sound rip apart. Now I'm just really pushing the sound in. But you can see how hard you have to push the sound for this to really take, you know, effect. All right, so here's before. Let's start pushing into the saturator. So I wouldn't use it on like vocal stuff because it seems like it's more of a smattering than it is like a drive signal, if that makes sense. It's more of a ripping apart, a destruction, whereas drums, perfect for this type of sound. Drums and bass. As you guys can hear, as I crank the drums going into, it's starting to sound crunchy. So you can get a lot of attitude out this EQ. I just wanted to test it to see the exact harmonic distribution that we were getting. This is a very geeky video. Wasn't perfect all the way through as far as gain matching, pardon me. But hopefully you guys can understand the concept of driving the signal into Pro Q4 until you get harmonics. And the lesson for today is it takes a lot of driving that signal to even get this thing to activate for most of you guys. So if you guys click this button on the character button, don't think that this is gonna magically turn everything into something right away. You're probably gonna have to push the signal pretty heavy to get to where you're trying to go. That was the science experiment for today. Subscribe if you're new. If you want to learn how to mix, go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. We have over 68 music production courses. Look for mixing fundamentals. I'll teach you guys the foundations of mixing, like delay, EQ, compression, all that stuff you need to know, loudness, etc., etc., clipping. and how to mix beats and hip hop as well, and vocals and acoustic material too. So just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. We have something called the Black Box Bundle, which is our end of the year offer, where you get all of my stuff in one. You get 68 music production courses, you get 6 plugins that I've created, and you get our sound packs all in one. So check it out, busyworksbeats.com/premium. Peace out, guys. Subscribe if you're new. Peace.